Guys, welcome back to Strong Successful Male. So for today, I'm going to go over an email that was sent from one of my female subscribers. Don't get many of those, so this is actually worth doing. And pretty much she wants to know, what are good qualities and values that women can have to be attractive? What are good qualities and values that I myself find attractive in women that could obviously help women get a right guy? Now, I'm going to do this on the basis that she's being completely sincere, that she wants to obviously hear my opinion on this, learn about these qualities and traits, and obviously to help her situation, not, I repeat, not to become a bait-and-switch girlfriend, which means that a woman picks up these traits to help her get a guy, be in a relationship with her, move in with her, or marry her, and then the second she's got him, drops all those qualities, and her true ugly self comes out, okay? I know I'm exaggerating here, but that stuff does happen here. I'm on the basis that she's being sincere here. So I'm going to go through her very quick email here, and I'm going to list 10 different things, in my opinion, I think are very good qualities that I find attractive in a woman. So starts off, "Hi, Mr. Strong Successful Male. I'm not making fun of you. I just don't know your name. My other option was going to be Mr. Shades because of the sunglasses. Call me SSM. I've been watching your content for a while, 3 to 4 months, and I have to say that some of the stories you are telling are quite the horror stories, like the recent one where the woman is suing for child support and the man was watching the kid while she worked. Wow. That was a story I did a couple weeks ago. It was a crazy story. Guy was watching this girl's kid while she was at work because she had no other options. He was trying to help her out. He's being sincerely kind and helping her. He moves out of the building and she tries to sue him for child support because, you know, she'd have to pay for it otherwise, even though he was babysitting the kid for free. Crazy. But it was a very popular video. Anyway, the reason I'm writing this email is that I'm genuinely curious if you have any advice for your women subscribers. What qualities or values you think people should have but have gotten lost in modern dating? What would be your version of a strong, successful female? Thank you for your time and keep up with the content." So, all right. So I'm going to list 10 qualities, in my opinion, are a great qualities to a woman to have that would definitely get my attention, okay? Definitely things that are a great girlfriend type of material, all right? So the first one is, number one, and this is in no particular order except for number one. Number one, looks. I know a lot of people hate to hear this, especially women, but like I said 10,000 times over, men are visual creatures. We're attracted to what we see. Therefore, a woman must, I repeat, must take care of her body, take care of her looks. That means she needs to be thin. I don't mean Victoria's Secret models of 1998 thin, which their entire diet consisted of cigarettes and coffee. That's disgusting. I'm talking thin, looking pretty. So she's hitting the gym. She's doing cardio. She's lifting weights, making her body toned. She is on a good diet, eats healthy, okay? You are what you eat, no joke. You fill your body with poison, you're going to turn into poison, okay? Aside from the working out front, she obviously has her hair long. She obviously goes to the salon and gets it done. She invests in herself with that regard. Dress is sexy, nice nails, makeup, not too much makeup. She doesn't need to look like a clown, but a little makeup, those type of things. That is a number one thing for guys. That is a deal breaker. A woman can have all these other great qualities, but if she doesn't do it for us in the looks department, doesn't make a difference how cool she is, how great she is. Doesn't matter. Number one, looks. Absolutely. Number two, and this is equally as important in my opinion as number one, she's got to be feminine. In today's world, guys, more and more women are embracing their masculine side thanks to the you-know-what movement. And you got movies and television and media brainwashing women that they have to be this way. Okay? It is a complete turnoff. Masculine men are completely repelled by masculine women. It's like having two dudes in a relationship. Therefore, the more feminine the girl is, the more she's going to be attractive to guys that are more into their masculine side. Now, you get guys that are more into their feminine side, guys that were obviously raised by strong mamas. The mom ran the show, and grandma was strong, and auntie was strong, and, you know, pretty much bossed the dad around. Those type of guys like stronger, more masculine women. But majority of men like feminine girls. And when I say feminine, I mean soft and kind and easygoing and nurturing and all that type of thing, okay? Not this army chick type of thing. It's a complete turnoff. Feminine. Number three, She is supportive. This really goes into girlfriend type of thing, guys. Number three, she is very supportive of our goals and ambitions, okay? That's a must. If you are a guy on your purpose and you're trying to make something of yourself in this life, if you got a girl that you're with, that's your girlfriend, and she is always being a pain in the ass for all your attention all the time and trying to take you away from your purpose, it's not going to work, okay? You need a woman that is going to be behind you in that, not just because she can benefit from that, but also that she generally respects and admires you for what you're trying to accomplish, even if it takes years. Unfortunately, in today's world, a lot of women are so entitled that they don't want a guy until he's already reached the finish line. Okay, they don't want the guy on the journey there. But if you get a girl that actually can be supportive, sincerely supportive of the guy who's trying to make something of himself, that's a big deal. Very important. Number four, minimal drama. Now, I say minimal drama because if I say no drama, that's unrealistic. All women enjoy a little bit of drama. All women are going to get a little dramatic from time to time. We all know this, okay? And so let's just cut the BS and call it for what it is. Minimal drama, okay? I don't need that kind of crap in my life, and guys generally do not, okay? These guys keep walking by my car here like they're stalking me or something. This is freaking me out. If somebody shows up and holds me up, I at least got this for you guys to obviously bear witness to me being held up here, carjacked. Anyhow, number five, loyal. Loyalty is huge. We can actually trust you, trust what you say, trust what you do, trust you're not going to go cheat on us with our best friend or brother or somebody else. Okay, loyalty is huge. And unfortunately, in today's world, how things are, it's almost like women are starting to be encouraged to not be loyal, actually encouraged to cheat on guys. It's crazy. But I know you guys know what I'm talking about because you've heard a lot of the articles and stories I've gone over. Number six, a good communicator. Guys, in relationships, if that's what you're going to do, communication is key. You can't be with some girl that's passive aggressive and something goes on and she's just going to have it all bottled up inside and not communicate in a healthy manner about it. And instead, get back at you later on down the road. It's crazy, okay? Now, when I say communicate, guys, I always tell you guys, don't go pouring out your emotions and fears and crying in front of your lady, okay? That's acting like a little bitch, okay? If you want to communicate, you can do it in a strong, masculine manner. You talk about what's going on and so forth. That's what I'm talking about. And you need a girl that's going to be the same way, okay? If there's something upsetting her, instead of starting a whole bunch of drama and picking fights and all that kind of crap, that she's going to communicate with you and tell you, you know, what's on her mind. And she'll learn to explain it to you in a way that in a way that a guy can understand. Step one, step two, step three. She doesn't drop hints and hope that we're going to figure it out. Ladies, dropping hints or using innuendos or that type of crap, generally speaking, is not going to work out. Even the best of us that can see through that stuff, it's much better that you're very direct and to the point, telling us what's bothering you, what you need, what you want, whatever. Again, this, guys, this is for a girlfriend type of stuff. Next one, number seven, old-fashioned values. And what I mean by that is not what we got today, okay? I don't need to elaborate what old-fashioned values are. You guys know what I'm talking about. It could literally be like the small-town girl next door back when the small-town girl next door actually behaved like the small-town girl next door. Nowadays, the small-town girl next door is on OnlyFans. You know what I mean there with the old-fashioned values. Number eight. And this is mostly for me, but a lot of guys are obviously on their purpose. That she is successful in her own right. Now, I said a million times over, when it comes to attraction, what we are physically attracted to, at the end of the day, it boils down to looks. So literally, you could have a girl that works at Dunkin' Donuts or Target or is at the register Burger King, and we'll find her more attractive physically, depending on her looks and body type, compared to some woman that's average, but has 3 degrees, has a high position in her company, makes 300 grand a year. We're going to find the girl at Dunkin' Donuts or Target more attractive. However, if she already is physically attractive and she's successful in her own right, a lot of us find that cool. I do. Okay. I like women that are entrepreneurs. I think women that do well for themselves is really cool. And also because I do very well for myself, obviously, if you want someone in the same tax bracket, okay? Guys, if you're doing very well for yourself and you make a lot of money, you know, you want to be very careful dating someone that works, that makes very little money per year, okay? And I'm not trying to knock them. I'm just saying it's not going to work because there's a strong possibility that you could be used, okay? But if you got a girl that's making something, she's in your tax bracket, you know, it's kind of even there. You got an equal. You see what I mean? Number 9, fun. Simple as that, fun. Easygoing, fun to be around. Who wants to be around someone that is always has a stick up their ass, okay? You want someone that's easygoing, that can have a good time, that you can have fun pretty much doing anything in, okay? It's not that hard. It's not rocket science. I don't need to elaborate too much about that, but it's just a pleasant person to be around, okay? Someone that's fun, makes you feel good, and so forth. And number 10, a good sense of humor. I know that's cliche, but for me, I'm a smartass, okay? And I'm sarcastic, and I joke around all the freaking time, okay? And so I need someone that can handle me in that regard and know I'm kidding and can definitely banter with me and all that. That's how I am. But someone that can obviously laugh, have a good time, and not take things too seriously, okay? Because believe me, what I do here on this channel, here on YouTube, as well as TikTok and Clapper and the other things, believe me, it pisses a lot of people off, okay? And a lot of women. I have a lot of women that hate my guts and would love to see me burned at the stake right in their front yard, okay? But it would take someone with a good sense of humor and to understand that, you know, not to take it too seriously and get too crazy about it. And, of course, is joking around, having fun. So there you go, getting right to the point. 10 things, okay? And quick review. Looks, being feminine, being supportive, minimal drama, loyal, good communicator, old-fashioned values, successful in her own right, fun, and good sense of humor. So, ladies are watching this. You possess these traits, especially the top ones with the taking care of your body, being feminine, good communicator, loyal, and all that. You're going to be doing pretty well. But be real about this. Do not say, okay, I'm going to do these things, trap myself a high-value man, and the second I got him, I can drop all these things and be a bitch. No, I'm not talking about that. These are things you want to possess to be a better person, you know, and be the type of person that'll attract a guy just like that. So, there you go. So, the lady asked me that. There you go. Good luck on your quest. So, anyhow, guys, that's it for today. Be sure to comment down below. Let me know what you think about this. And be sure to like the video, share with your friends, and subscribe. And I'll catch you next time.